5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Clockwork!
Dire Team ban.
Hi.
I just saw that I could, oh man, I'm not having a good day today. I just forgot to put on my mic. So now my stream didn't hear that. So let's start that one over. Welcome to the Corsair Gaming Arena number 5. This is the match between Execration and Signature Trust. Signature Trust was able to win their match. Execration as well. I didn't watch the Signature Trust one, but Execration, they had a bit of a dip in the mid-game, gave away some unnecessary kills, but in the end, they were able to win quite convincingly. Here's a little bit lesser-known team, so now versus Signature Trust, they're not able to make these mistakes. And let's go into it. As said before, with me is Pisa from Join Dota.
Hello, it's Pazzi.
Pazzi, damn it, I'm a little bit with the name. Pazzi from Join Dota.
Hello.
10 seconds. This is her first time casting, guys, so give her some love. Be nice to her. 5 seconds
remaining. Oh, God.
We're going to have the VOD online soon as well of this, so it could be fun as well. Let's just look a little bit into the draft. What do you think so far, especially of what Signature Trust has been able to pick up? Storm
Spirit. Well, sorry, I'm not used to this.
I know. God. This is just fun to put you on the spot a little bit.
Well, they got this Storm Spirit. It's huge, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he's always been an annoying hero, and unless they pick something, like, they've got the Earthshaker and the Clockwork, but I don't think that would be enough to, you know.
Stop the Storm Spirit. They don't have that, what is it? That long duration stuns or... But especially a silence.
The crowd control. Like, what's its face? Signature has somewhat crowd control, especially if they pick up someone with like a big stun. Maybe that's it. Like the Witch Lion. Doctor would have been good, but he got banned. Radiant. I don't know.
Well, Signature Trust also, of course, has an Undying Gyrocopter combination, which they picked up straight after one another. Making sure that Execration is not able to get the Gyrocopter here themselves to just clean away these zombies with their flak cannon. And the Dying just being this annoying lane control hero, so strong in the early game. And you really have to watch out with the DPA stacks there. Remaining. What do you think Signature Trust might be looking for? An aggressive tri lane here? Remaining. Undying Gyrocopter plus something else? Or opting off lane and
reserve time. I'm not actually sure, but they might. Dire team pick. It would be a good off. I mean, maybe the other team. How do you pronounce their name? I don't know how to pronounce their name. I don't know if they're gonna put the clockwork. Yeah. I don't know if they're gonna put the clockwork on his own. But it would be. Templar assassin. I don't know. I'm really nervous. Just don't ask me.
It's cute. No, take a breath. Think about it. Like,
I'm actually like sweating right now.
You're
not very.
You're.
But.
Sweating. Oh, you're dead nervous for a guest.
Yes, I have. what's it? What's it called? 10 seconds remaining. I don't even know words now. 5 seconds remaining.
Sorry, I shouldn't laugh at that.
But my pain. Okay, very nice.
Want me to take it over a little bit here?
Yes, please.
Okay. Okay, so Execration is picking up the TA here. The Refraction is pretty nice, though. They already have, of course, a Gyrocopter as well. It's actually the Undying Zombies who are able to tick through it quite easily. Which means that it loses some of the value, though. It's strong lane control versus the Storm Spirit in mid. It blows up the Undying as well as the Rubick quite easily. So it has that really going for him. Though the problem is that you're also already facing up versus a Razor. And being a TA, you don't have that really long range attacks. Which means that you have to try and get in close. And versus a Razor with a static link, you will lose all of your damage. And that will be a problem for the TA to look into. Might pick up a blink here just to either blink out of a static link. Or maybe blink in and try to blow up someone before all her damage is completely stolen. It's not really a hero that you pick up a Linkosphere on, so that's probably the best option to go. And so far, yeah, it's also nice. Both as well, the Clockwork, the Earthshaker are heroes that get close into you and stand. For Razor, that's really, really strong. The Lion, it's okay for Razor. It does have a pretty big blow-up potential as well for the Storm and Gyrocopter. They're not that heavy HP hero, so you're quite able to blow them up in your game. At least until maybe BKBs come out. What do you think of a couple of the bands here, the Broodmother of Execration? What do you think of the band there?
Well, I don't know. I've seen it a lot. I've seen people pick Undying with Weaver or Broodmother. I think it's all about the slow and the slow, like, killing. I don't know, like, yeah, the Weaver. I don't know. They like bugs. They like tiny critters that attack people, I guess, in towers.
You're talking about a kind of like a zoo / animal pest control idea here, where they just pick up all the lizard, spider kind of lineup and just go with it.
I'm terrible at this.
It's fun. It's fun to try stuff like this from time to time. You will get into it, you know, during the game, you know. You see things happen. Pick a Ben stage is always the toughest thing to do because it's just the toughest thing. You have to see and look into what possible things are there, like how you're going to assess what's going to be happening and... That's hard. Even I stumble upon it like all the time. Or say stupid stuff. Usually the latter one.
Are you saying that I'm saying stupid stuff?
Let's just Not gonna have a real. Might have to do some admining soon.
Pardon?
Lumic deceit.
Oh man.
Just happy I don't
have help here. Let's hope he reconnects.
Yeah, let's hope so. Why don't you just go over the lineups here? For Execration, we have Lumic playing the Lion. Vox is going to be playing the Earthshaker. Abeng is going to be playing the Weaver. Primo is going to be playing the Clockwork. And Nano is going to be playing the mid lane Templar Assassin here for Execration on the Dire side. Do you want to take the Radiant side? Signature Trust?
Oh, pardon, I didn't listen to anything.
No, that's cool. Just, you want to introduce Signature Trust?
Okay. There's, I don't know if... Lakels.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Is on the Gyrocopter, my pro on the Razor, Jab on the Rubik. Mao is on the Undying and Stand-In, he's on Storm.
Yeah, that went pretty well.
Oh, God.
You're really nervous, aren't you?
You're me. Like, I'm not even... My face is crimson right now.
If you Skyped and I could put up, like, your webcam here.
Oh, my God. I might actually, like, I don't know. This is, yeah, okay.
You want to keep on trying it till the end?
I'm not sure I can emotionally, like,
Well, if it's too much, just tell me and then I will just mute myself on TS and keep going forward from it there along. Okay, well... Well, everybody, this is the Corsair Gaming Arena number 5. This is the quarterfinal between Execration and Signature Trust. This is a best of 1. The winner of this game is going to be facing up in the semi-final against either Arcanus or MSI EFOX. I hope Arcanus wins because that's a name that I can actually pronounce. How's the planning actually for today? You know that, right? All the other matches?
Pardon? I'm sorry, I'm working on the match thingy.
Okay. I was just wondering, what's the agenda for today? Are all round two matches going to be played today and then round three and final tomorrow? Or are you not sure?
I'm not quite sure, but there's a lot of matches going on. Like, there's several as we speak. There will be more in an hour. Like, just like, you know.
Matches stuff. All day long.
Yeah. Or at least until the afternoon. Oh, God.
Well, at least we're now back into the game as Lumic has been able to reconnect to it. Box throws, always throws out some random stuff in the beginning of the match in the fountain. Wants to make sure that his skills work. As we see him pick up the fissure. It's gonna be the defensive tri-lane here coming out from Execration. They do have pretty self-sustainable heroes here, which means that the two supports can go and roam from the beginning on out. Because you can just leave the Weaver alone on the top lane. Clockwork is okay here on the bot, especially being on the Dire. You're able to just put away those the creeps in the woods there. As we're gonna see an aggressive tri-lane here, as I thought out before from Signature Trust here. We're gonna try and make this lane here so much harder for the site of Execration, and we'll see how it is gonna end up. They do have a fairly strong tri-lane here for Signature Trust, with the Rocket Barrage being able to just destroy people. I did get nerfed a little bit in 6.84, but it's still fairly strong. Ooh, but Nendo, he's going in aggressive here. Though the gyrocopter is fairly slow, and he now has his teammate to back him up. And oh, just the refraction was gone instantly. But there is going to be the Earth Spike as well on top of Lakels. He's still running after Nendo. Nendo has to look out. He's going to start getting more of this laser rocket barrage on top of him. He's able to live just through it with about 100 HP.
They also clipped the lion. They clipped the lion.
They clipped the lion. Oh, no. Oh, he's going to be stuck here for quite some time. He can buy his downport scroll and about 30 more gold, but yeah, this is a little bit annoying for him here, I would say. I didn't even see that. Oh my god. Well, this means that you're effectively having a tri-lane versus a dual lane here on bot, on top, I mean. I don't think that was how he wanted to start his game here. Have you ever been cliffed before, or?
I have. It was very sad.
How long were you stuck?
5 minutes? 4 minutes? I don't know.
So you received an abandon. Well, that sounds great.
No, I didn't. Like, it takes like... I don't know. Like, I was waiting. I think we upgraded the courier by the time I got down. Like, I had to upgrade it. I'm not sure. Because there were bullies and the Rubik kept coming back. It's very sad.
They were just being mean against you the entire game then.
But he lost a lot because he just stayed there next to me when he should have been online. So he lost more XP than I did.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, I caught up. Got it.
Oh. Well, Lion, you know, with the recent changes, you're able to put a TP from the courier onto yourself or from one of your teammates onto the cliff when you're cliffed, so they nerfed the cliffing a bit in that sense, so. But still, it's annoying. You lose about 1 to 2 minutes of farming and experience.
I was like position 5, no one even cared. Except like my friends. But no one cared.
They just leave you there like, eh. You're not important, you're just a support, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, they're making a go here on the Storm Spirit on bot, but Fissure a little bit late. Primo went in aggressive before Fox was able to get into position. As my pro here. Mid is taking a lot of damage from Nendo. He does have his bottle already, so he is okay. Nendo is just looking for this annoying Psy hits on top of my pro. Did get his bottle quite a lot earlier. He's almost double the CS of what Nendo is. Oh, steady link on top of him. And then it just starts running away. This one cost him 42 damage already. This top lane has been quite calm. Nothing has really been happening. They're not being willing to dive on top of this Weaver right now. They're doing a lot of damage to him. Oh, this might be a mistake from him. Ah, bang, he's gonna go down. This is gonna be the first blood going away of Lakels. Yeah, I don't think he knew that there was going to be a sentry down there, and he just got off guard quite hard, and he even denied the totem in front of Lumic here. That's sad for him. Primo, he's going to go get his bottle now, so it's going to be double bottles here on the side of Execration, meaning that they have to really control these lanes quite well. As Jeb, he's gonna get caught off. He's gonna get a lift off on Abang, but it doesn't matter. Lumic is able to pick up the kill there. Timo gets his boots and starts putting in some DKs here. Lakels is now back here, joining into the fray. At the moment, it's just calming down a little bit more. Nendo has been able to get back up here with his last hit. Just two down on my pro here on mid, so. Well, Lakels has been able to. Oh, they got a kill on the clockwork here on bot. Jeb was able to rotate in, lift him up, fade bolt on top of him, and they killed him. Dire's top tower isn't well at the moment. Oh, this sentry here on bot. Oh, this is pretty devastating here. This is just outside of the range. I don't think Jeb's like that. That's pretty much a waste of sentry here. Dire's bottom
tower is in turmoil. Could have placed it between, like, I don't even know. I don't know why he placed it there.
They want to have the medium other camp. Places. They want to have the medium camp free for pulling and stacking, and I thought he might have just put it in the middle of the camp here. He put it just outside of it, still blocks it, and because of that, you know, this sentry is kind of on top. They get another kill here on Abeng on the Weaver. He dies. Now they're looking after Fox. He has 2 DK stacks on top of him as the Rock Barrage from Lakels kills him off. A double kill going their way. Well, in the middle, Signature Trust is just not letting go. They pick up another kill here. My pro is able to kill off the Templar Assassin. Seems like they didn't even use the static link here. So far, Signature Trust getting a firm control of the early game here. 5-1 already, picking up the first blood, as well as 4 additional kills, and just that one kill for Execration on the Rubick. As they're gonna go after Primo here. He hooks it in. Jeb's taking a lot of damage, but I don't think he's able. Oh, now they cliff Jeb here. Is Primo actually able to live from this? No. Oh, there's gonna be the solve as well. Jeb is stuck here. They might gonna try and Psyblade him, but yeah, dude. They're able to get out of here, but they do get a kill on him. As on top, they also get a kill on the gyrocopter. Primo, he gets he says, hello, how are you doing? Better result on top of you, and you're gonna die here as well, because he's not able to zip away from this. Execution, they strike back with 3 kills of their own in a rapid succession here. As now Nendo, he's gonna get static link. He just lost all of his damage here versus the Hasted Brazier, and just look at this damage here. Fox is gonna take a fall. Over 200 damage on top on him right now. Nendo, if he just gets one poke, he's already down to half HP. And there you go. Not half, that was a little bit of an over-exaggeration. Well, he actually just lost the damage here, though. Now on top, Lakels, he's just dominating this lace. 32 less hits versus the 24 of Abeng. And Abeng, he's just scared. He can't get in close. He is way too squishy. One rocket barrage almost kills him off instantly. As though there's a lot more trading here in the middle. Again, Razor dies as well as Fox. Now Jab is going to be the next one on the list. He's now able to pick him off before the TP comes in. TP cancelled, but Jab stays all around. Nando is there still. Again, a one-for-one trade. Worth it for Execration here, killing off the mid lane for just their support Earthshaker here. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. This is stack, no, this is kind of odd. Might be able to still stack it or at least pull. There we go. Bottom tower is on its way. Just trying to deny all XP and farm here for the side of Signature Trust on the top lane. And dying is really just standing here doing nothing at the moment. I'm kind of unsure what they're gonna do here while Jeb is in middle. Trying to help out my pro. Nando has an invisibility room, but I don't think he knows that they actually have a sentry down here. He buffs his refreshing charge. There's gonna be the fishing from Fox as well. Making sure they won't follow up on this. Though Nando now has a lot of minus damage already, and it's kind of hard to withstand versus this. But his refreshing charge is gone, he's not really able to do a lot. As here on bot. Again, Primo having a pretty good time here on the clockwork. 31 less hits already. He's been given a lot of space here, just playing versus a solo Storm Spirit. Both of them don't really have the biggest of kill potential on them, but well, they're gonna get top in here. They're gonna go after Lakels. There's gonna be the battery assault. He's gonna get off a rocket barrage, but he's just gonna die here. Primo tanks it up like a man. While Abing is able to pick off the Undying as well. They're gonna try and transition this into a tier 1 push here. Two people down, and hey, he's gonna try and just go and get this tower here on bot. Maybe get a trade off if they're not able to push in fast enough here on the side of Execration. Oh my pro. Let's see what build is gonna be. Usually you tend to go for a mechanism build on the Razor. What do you think is my pro gonna go for this build this time around?
I mean, look, I'm actually tapped out. I'm so good. Well, I'm not actually sure, to be honest.
You think Mechanism, Sanjay Yasha, BKB?
I really like Sanjay Yasha on this hero, but I'm not... And the speed, like, having the speed on him is actually gonna benefit him a lot. He's already been bothering the TA, who's just started catching up. So, I'm not actually sure on how he wants to go from here. I'm clueless.
But at least you have a clear favorite. You want to say, oh, Abang taking a lot of damage. Yeah, he has to time lapse away from there and he just starts to secure you back in. Lakels is kind of stuck here still, although. But he's able to juke around the lion here as Nando comes in. Static Link on top of him. Hey, it goes after Fox here. Well, my pro is walking forward. There's going to be a hookshot in from Primo as well. He's looking for Lakels, but he's taking a lot of return damage. He's able to get a kill though while he is laying in some damage on top of Primo. And Primo will take a fall here. They're going to try and go after my pro here. Oh, Nando got almost the full damage here from that one. But 3-for-2 trade here in the favor of Signature Trust. But it's going to be the Mechanism first here on my pro. I would like the Sanjay Yasha as well. You make a pretty good case here with, you know, giving the extra damage as well as movement speed and a little bit more tankability. Those are all kind of things that a Razor would like to have.
Were you talking?
Yeah, I was just acknowledging what you said.
Yeah, I heard something about the Sanjay Yasha, but I thought I heard a question.
No.
Sorry. Okay, I think I can now save here.
You're gonna be here completely?
No, but I'll try.
Oh, the totem is down. Signature Trust is trying to go for a tier 1 push here. What do you think of this totem? It was kind of immature.
Yeah, I think he thought that they could go on it.
Yeah, it was a little bit too aggressive. A little bit too fast as well. This is just this 5-man deadball pretty much from TI4 from Signature Trust. They're just grouping up, getting mechas and trying to push down things here as... Might... They actually want to play like that. We might gonna see a Razor with... Ooh. Well, that thought, but they're gonna go into Nando here. He's taking a lot of damage, you just need a little bit more. Hey, he just comes down, goes after Nando, but Nando is still alive. What are they doing? This is... I don't know what Hey is doing. He's just going all over. They're just playing with their dinner here. As Lem... I mean, he just walked through it casually and walks away. Primo is looking for her, but he's able to walk away. That was really weird.
Yeah, and the TA decided to go for a very interesting build, maxing out her side blades instead of going for Melm to clear out stacks. Maybe she wants to go for her Desolator before she actually starts to join in.
Yeah, she will need to Desolator. It's basically a synergy with a Desolator as well. Oh, that's a blown up Lacalse. Fissure, Earth Spike, as well as Finger of Death are more than enough to kill him off. And now they're gonna go after Lumid here. Ripro is stealing all this damage. He's gonna go well over the 200 almost. As he just kills him off casually there with the Plasma Field. Oh, hookshot in him to Jeb. Fissure is there as well. They're gonna kill him off. Oh, the Fissure. The stolen. Oh, it was actually stolen Finger there. Almost enough to kill off Fox here. They're looking for Mypro now. He just lost all of his damage. He gets off a plasma field, scouting out everybody. He's just gonna steal damage away from Nando here. Nando is not able to get this one off, so he's not gonna do anything right now, but at least his team is there to help him out.
It seems like he's actually going for the mechanism. He's pretty close to it right now. I don't know if you mentioned that.
I mentioned it. I kinda did.
Okay, we can have it does,
but yeah, you're right. He is indeed going for the mecha. He's just getting fairly close to it as well.
Oh my god, I'm so useful. This is a brilliant idea.
It's fun to try. Oh, it's a Kushin Rubik. This is just a fun steal to have as a Rubik.
Yeah, they actually have a lot of nice spells for Rubik to take. Like, all of Lion's spells are actually useful. Even, I'm not sure about the mana drain, but you get a lot from the Hex or the Sun. And the LP, of course. Although and the Earthshaker.
Earthshaker's with the Fissure, that's probably the best one. Having the instant Fissure is just ridiculous.
Yeah. They gain so much from their own their enemies' crowd control, which is actually really nice.
They're just able to turn that around with Rubik there. He's just waiting here with the Shikuchi ready to go into and initiate here. Well, they pop the buckler, giving some more armor and maybe go into the boost for real now, but they seem to be willing to just fiddle around a little bit more while the creep wave gets cleared and they now all have to return back. As a little bit more issues for the side of Signature Trust now. Maybe a little bit of a leg spike. I think he's just split pushing. What do you think of his... Because this is going to be a Linka Sphere build from Abang. What do you think of it?
I had my mic muted. I'm sorry. I was all right. For the hot key.
I'm
not sure about it, but it can help help him avoid, for example, the Rubik's telekinesis and most of anything that can hold him down if he pulls off his pay for his turnaround. I'm not sure, but I don't think it's a bad choice, but could have gone for something else too. Since Lincolns can only do so much, but he can't really escape any of, for example, Earthshaker's spells or.
He is with Earthshaker.
Oh god, I'm sorry. Then I'm sorry, I got confused. Don't look at me.
Well, okay, let's forget about that while they get the tier 1. Yep. Oh, he goes in with the Shikuchi. He's trying to find someone here, but Fox is able to just walk inside. Oh, they find Primo. There's going to be the call down on top of him. He pops the blade mill and the haze. And he's looking for a reinitiation with the hookshot, but he just canceled it. I quite like the pickup for Link's Sphere here. Just for the static Link, it's already that good, as well as the lift up and those kind of things, the vortex to pull him back. Oh, Nando. He was lucky that they just spawned an invisibility rune there. But yeah, just to finish up on that, he doesn't have to go like a Desolator first, because that's already something that the TA is doing. It means that he can open up for a little bit more defensive items here and maybe later on into an MKB or maybe a possibility of going a crit stake early as well. As I actually saw the TA walking in here with the sentry ward here, so they should know that this is going on, and Signature Trust does. They're walking in here. It's gonna be the plasma field. There comes out the plasma field. Oh, buddy! Kill of one. They're gonna go after Primo here first, but hey, he's gonna die. Fox goes down. Nando is gonna be the next one to get a four-man wipe here. As they were just completely caught with their pants down here in the rush pit. They lose the Aegis. They lose four people, and the only one who's still alive is Abeng, just casually farming up the mid lane. And don't you think that was really, really aggressive? And he gets his security back. Do you think that that was really just a good call to make to go for rush there?
For, well,
execration?
Actually, no, because they had to trade for nothing. They actually gave so much to the enemy team. Even though, like, the Storm Spirit was already at the top, no one was actually getting to him. But I'm not sure. Don't think it was a good idea, and he just got his Orchid. Only benefited him, I suppose.
Storm was in the fight, actually. The one that was farming top was Abeng.
No, I mean, like, he was actually getting a lot out of it. And he was positioned nicely, like on the cliff. No one was even noticing him. I don't know, I like that.
He was able to catch Primo there. Well, actually, Primo tried to catch him there, and then he got stuck on the cliff himself. Yeah, let's see how it goes right now. It's gonna be the linkage for Abeng, but it's kind of late. He's not gonna get it in time since the Orchid's already out, and they're looking here for a pretty aggressive push. Get off the cocks on my pro, he has to walk around the Fisher as well. But I don't think they can really get this tower in time. This entirety of Signature Trust, apart from Lakels, is already rotating in. First item, DKB, Lakels. What do you think of that? Maybe a Sanjay Yasha first would have been better, or an HOD, or what's your opinion on this?
It helps them survive most of their spells. Like, they have a lot of crowd control, and if he can avoid that during the fight, I think then he can go on from there. But I'm not sure how that's gonna pan out. So, you know, things and stuff and things. I don't know. But I think it's a good thing to go for, but I'm not sure about the timing.
That's what I was also wondering. Like, it's so early to go for this item. Just 20 minutes in. That said, they're looking already to maybe try and end this with the aggression they're putting out, but or at least gets a lot of map control. Maybe they can get their worth out of it like that. But I think my pro Virtue, he's gonna go for Sanjay Yash, or at least that's what's gonna be looking like. But actually, kill off Hehe here. He's gonna get, he got a finger in his face and he died of it.
I don't know how you do this. I'm actually like, this is like really stressful. How do you do this? So like,
that's okay.
I don't.
You're trying it, so. Oh, Jeb, what? What's Jeb doing here? This guy, that's just way out of position and. Yeah, this is kind of like a feed here. Well, they're gonna try and catch somebody off guard, but yeah, they have enough TPs here, and they kind of got spotted out here on the side of Signature Trust by the creep wave. They're able to get off a safe retreat for execration while they get back some kills, some momentum. Signature Trust isn't really that far ahead as I thought it would be. Only about just under 5k gold, as well as just under 3k experience as well. One thing that they have is really just all these goals on the three cores. Three cores are fairly far ahead against the course of execration. So one thing that they have, I think that Fox already has his blink there now. That's kind of ballsy, but oh, what? Random courier flies through here. They see this? This is out of range. The signature. They're looking for another push. They're gonna try and get this tier 2 on top. The last remaining outer tower for execration. They don't seem too willing to defend at the moment because they're just now rotating in. They might actually already lose it before that. Oh, Fox, he gets lifted up. He's not able to do to get up a good Echo Slam now. That said, he doesn't even have it. Totem drop down and they're looking to chase the side of Execration down. And but Mendo, he walks in. He gets up a pretty nice melt strike here on Micro, but now he walked up to Slakels. That's not the person you want to walk up to. Oh, he just survives here. Well, Primo goes in. Fighting for Slakels. Slakels is going to take a fall here. Didn't pop his BKB and he also already lost the Aegis. Primo is going to die here. And so far, one for one trade as he is still able to get out. Now they're going to go back to farming here and going to try and get... No, they're going to leave it now. The P's come in and... What, Jeb? He is... Again, he's kind of alone here and he's going to get found out again here. Oh, he does have the fissure to be able to stall a little bit, but there's just the easy melts right into Finger to blow him up. Does he want to go for Nando here? It's kind of a long shot as... Gonna go and try and get Fox here. But he uses his Fissure. My pro's fairly low. Nando comes in here as well. Totem drop down. He's gonna get one hit on Tomb by now, but it's not enough as he gets drained. A little bit of damage here, but there's gonna be the melt on top of My pro to kill him up. They're gonna go after it. Whoa, call down here, but it doesn't hit Fox though. By now is able to get out. Lakels comes in here. Oh, Primo, what the hell did he go for? Well, doesn't matter. Lakels is just trying to fight up versus Nando here, and that's not the fight that he can take. Three kills for the side of Execration here, of which a double goes the way of Nando. This was something that Execration has been needing. This means that it's going to be pretty much near even right now. Dumik, oh, he got this blink right now. Faimo has to look out. If he finds him, he can just insta-X him. Oh yeah, he's going to walk into his own jungle and just going to try and get away from it. Dumik is able to get off a pretty aggressive ward here on the pillar. Setting them up for a nice tier 2 push here. It's the A though. It's really just the saving grace for Execration. Oh, Jeb. He got Fissure. Earth Spike as well. Do they have? No, they don't really have anything to follow it up. Apart from Primo who just comes in now. He's going to get thrown out of the cox. Is Jeb going to survive? No, he is not. There's going to be the rocket and Primo gets out. Lumic, oh yeah, he's just gonna die here. Long zip in from Hehe. Organ on top of him. Nice overload hit as well, and they just kill him off. What do you think is gonna be the build now for TA? Gonna go for maybe a BKB now, or opting for a more offensive item?
I'm not actually sure. Maybe more offensive items? I'm not actually sure, but she actually, she's doing fine so far. I expected her to be a little, you know, she's added net worth and other things, so that's
it's about because I was ahead of the storm.
Yeah, and she went for Silent Slaves first, but apparently it worked for her.
Did you see the pickup just on top on the storm? She was just trying to lay a trap. She kind of missed the melt strike there. But it didn't matter. She was still able to just blow him up.
It was just like free hits and so on. But also like the Earthshaker and the Lion are actually doing pretty good, especially in comparison to signatures.
Yeah, well, it is just as you said that Lumic and Fox are a little bit aggressive and they kind of die here. That's I'm not completely sure what they were trying to do there. They were trying actually to T ward, but it was fairly aggressive with none of their cores really nearby to help them out. They do get the tier 1 tower, I believe, for TA here or not. No, that was just a visual bug for me. Oh, Mendo, he's gonna get lift up, thrown back into the high ground here, but oh. He does get stopped here with the Urge Spike in the middle of it, but they're able to kill him off. Enough crowd control there. Killing spree going the way of Jab here. And he now has his 4-step. Well, Abeng is just split pushing here on top. Oh, Rush is back. Signature Thrust is gonna go for this. Do you think they're gonna get another good Roshan fight here, or is or is it not? Because last time Execration went for it, Signature Thrust punished them quite heavily. You think it's the same is gonna happen here, or with TA down, it's just gonna be an easy rush for Signature?
I'm not sure if it's gonna be easy, but I don't think that they're gonna go. Oh wow, they are getting in first.
Oh, big Echo Slam! There is gonna be the hookshot in as well. They're cocking them up. Storm is actually able to still at least get the Aegis here. Well, three people down in Execration. This was really aggressive, and they absolutely got nothing back for it. They got the Aegis, but yeah, really giving three kills away here as well as the gold on Roshan, I think. Actually got a, yeah, it was killed by the Radiant, so they killed it, they got Roshan, three kills as well. The only thing that Execration got for it was the Aegis. That's not worth it, I would say.
Yeah, well,
my pro, he at least finished up his Sanjay Yasha now. What do you think? We're gonna see like a refresher Aghanim's build here now on my pro? Or you think he's gonna opt for something else? Yeah, making you think here.
Thinking is hard. Actually, I don't know. Maybe. You're asking the wrong person, like. I'll just say yes. Is yes an answer?
Well, before we're gonna see that, he's gonna get ganked upon by what seems to be three people here right now from Execration. Hookshot on the mark. Fish, finger of death as well, and Weaver is able to pick up the last hit on it. A little bit of an aggressive move here, but they're trying to get something back here. Maybe a Signature Thrust are rotating in, but they think the better of it and move back to the mid lane. And now they smoke up. They weren't spotted by any wards, so they might be able to maybe find Nando here. Oh, zip in. They find him. Pull back Orchid as well. Refraction is gone. He's blown up. He spots his BKB, but that's kind of a waste of his BKB here as he just loses it straight away. Akels used his as well, so it's kind of a trade in that sense, but it's really worth it for Signature Thrust here. Even losing the Razor for this, it's kind of worth it to kill off the top farmer.
Yeah, they've been really setting trying to shut the TA down since the game started, and she does catch up, but it makes it harder for her to stay, for example, in lane.
Oh, hey, he is found. Echo Slam killed him off. Pick up by the two supports here from Execration. Primo was also in the neighborhood. He actually went here for the Ghost Scepter to make sure that he doesn't get those pesky right clicks on top of him. Does make him a bit more susceptible for the Rocket Barrage, but for that he has a simple answer. Just pop the Blade Mill and kill Akels with his own skills, unless he of course pops his BKB. They're gonna look for this, they don't have the finger for a minute, so this is kind of iffy. Maybe just, yeah, he just steals the XP here right now. And just refreshes up the wards, goes back, and calls it a day here in the jungle. Yeah, I want to say Slam is still on the... Yeah, Echo Slam is also still on cooldown. This is really aggressive from the supports here, from Execration, just farming up the enemy jungle. Not giving a damn here.
Did they drop the finger also to get the Sinister kill?
No, they used it.
Echo Slam.
They used Echo Slam for it. I don't think they used the finger. They used it before on the Razor on top. Well, Faimao, he's gonna get killed here in the river by Nando, and even Abeng comes around to steal a little bit of the experience and some gold. As the cooldown hits Wonder, trying to get in here. Jeff doesn't have anything stolen and only has his 4 steps to get closer. As Epsang, they're gonna go for the double Desolator here. usually you want to say, you know, it's, you don't need two of them on the team, but it also just gives the option for the Weaver to go and split push more on his own. Has he actually also got a gem here? Okay. Is it his? No, it's from Signature Trust. Oh, that kill there on the Undying was big. They were able to steal the gem from him. That's a big loss there for Signature Trust. Kels, he got his BKB still. He hasn't had any real progression since that. Well, Nando is just farming and farming and getting more farming in that sense. Like, he's just getting more and more ahead. One point it was down to just 1k difference, but he just quickly got it back to 3k again. Mirroring maybe his next item, which I'm gonna assume is gonna be either an MKB or a crit stick into a Daedalus. At least Signature Trust is able to deny one of your towers. But still, after they got so much in the early game, so much map control, they haven't been really able to capitalize on it afterwards. And now they're just getting pushed back by the side of Execration, who just pick up the pace with this heavy ganking squad with the supports and the clockwork just looking for them. But this is going to be a big smoke gank here. Are they going to walk through them? Nando gets off. And this is not going to be enough. Nando is going to get found. He goes invis, but he pops his BKB. He tries to turn his one on. Hey, he is almost dead. And he just blinks away here due to the refraction charges. And there is going to... It goes back into him. Melt. He's invis. Okay, there is going to be the dust. Pull in. Nando is dead. Primo's hookshot is too late. What did he hit there? Okay, it doesn't matter. And Seal dies as well. Jeff dies as well. Primo goes in. He's getting a lot of damage here from Lakels. He popped his BKB and doesn't matter about the blade mill here. It's going to be the Echo Slam from Fox, not doing enough damage here as Lakels just able to live through it. He pops his Ghost Scepter here as well, but it just means his own death pretty much as well. As Abang, he just picks up the totem and just starts his Sakuchi away from his. Not gonna get hit by the plasma field here. Throws down the swarm, but this is not a fight that he can take. This was really a kind of successful smoke here from Signature Trust. They're able to pick up two cores as well as one support for their Storm Spirit and as well as jab their support. Does the Storm Spirit have... he doesn't have a Bloodstone. He seems to be going for that now. Does mean that his Razor already has 3.7k gold, so we're soon gonna see if he's gonna go that Aghanim push build together with maybe a Refresher after that, or maybe offer to get a BKB here. Those are the two most likely options to really build into. Gyrocopter, 2.3k gold. He's either going to be looking at a Butterfly, which is a pretty viable option, or the MKB. Kind of just depends on what Nando wants to do. Well, Nando wants to go for an Assault Curious here, so I would say that the best option for Kels here now is to probably build up a Butterfly just to have that evasion, since the build up for Nando to the Assault Curious is gonna take some time. So before he has it, maybe you're able to get your own Butterfly by the same timing, or at worst, you know, he's only starting to get his first component on the MKB and it still has all of his worth for maybe one or two fights. The big question here is Abang then. What's he going to be building up? Well, he seems to be building up for a heart. He just wants to tech up and survive through all of it. It's okay, because they don't really need him to give out this big damage with the swarm synergy with the Meltstrike and the Desolators. There's already a lot of physical damage that will be just turned on top of the side of Signature Trust. So just going for health here is okay, but it does mean that they won't have an MKB on any of their two big or soon. Yes. We're gonna see Primo finish up his Aghanims here. See what he's gonna be looking at now. They're just really just occupying the entire jungle of Signature Trust at all time. Oh, another smoke gank here. They're gonna find the support here. Oh, Lumix sees them first. There's gonna be the storm popped, and they're just gonna go after Lumiki. Yeah, that's not gonna work. That was kind of 100 gold wasted there on the TP here. As Fox just puts down a fissure to save his own retreat. As Nando, they're gonna walk on top of him. He blinks out. He's gonna be okay. Ooh, hey, he wants to go after him, but he doesn't have enough mana to really follow up on the pursuit. So with the smoke, you just get a lie, and it's not really worth it at the moment. Because they have been occupying their the jungle for them so long that this timing that he's now dead, he already kind of made up for it. We're soon gonna see Roshan come back in about 10 seconds. That's gonna be the next major point of contest.
Yeah, they've been contesting every Rosh and they've been dying playing together.
Yeah, was it the first Rosh went the way of Execration, but the second one went pretty heavily in the favor then of Signature Thrust. Actually, both of them went for Signature Thrust, pardon me.
Yeah.
Was it the first one? The TA went Invis, she wasn't spotted, his team followed in with I believe, yeah, they were smoked, but they were already spotted out, and they kind of got a really shitty fight there. The other five, Signature Thrust, they went in, well, ooh, Nendo, he's in a whole lot of problems, and the problems will result in his own death here.
Thing is, the Gyrocopter and Storm Spirit are very strong heroes, so I'm not sure who'd be able to win this, and it seems like they're gonna, though they're not in the lead, they're quite powerful, you know?
Yeah, they're not out of it at all.
Yeah.
What do you think? If we're, let's say, we're talking about this game still goes on for at least a 30 minutes, who would you actually favor? Gyrocopter Storm Razor combination, or pretty much any late game for Execration? You only really have the Weaver and the TA.
Thing is, I have a thing for Rubik, so I'd go for Rubik.
You're gonna go for the signature side. You're gonna say Rubik is gonna win this game.
I'm not saying this game, but I'm saying this game went for it. Decade, yeah. This game, I don't know.
This game, like, you don't know.
It's, I don't know. Like, yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna say I don't know one more time and I'll stop.
Well, she doesn't know it. Signature Thrust knows what they wanna do. They wanna get some kills and stay. First kill off Fox here. Primo's gonna be the next one. Fox already bought back. Lumic is able to TP out. There's already two buybacks used to contest, to try and contest this rush. And now they need to go and do something. They can lose this rush, not with two buybacks already used. Rush is falling, Swarm has been there, they give them to some fishing as well as the as this traps there from the TA as well, and let's see what we're gonna wait for this big Echo Slim as the Totem get destroyed. Yeah, that one was a little bit too late to swarm with. Roshan down to 1500 HP, they need to go in now or they might just be too late. Oh, they go in just in the nick of time, but are they able to steal it? Oh, they actually got the kill as well, they steal it. Are they gonna get a good team fight of this? Nanopost is BKB men fighting up here, they're gonna get one kill. But they're already paid with two of their own deaths in return. This is gonna be the third death. Is the Aegis though? Is the TA able to blink out from this? No, she is not. Rocket Barrage straight on top of her face as she dies. Another good team fight at the rush pit for Signature Thrust. They seem to be the lords of the Roshan pit this game.
I think people just should try avoiding to rush when Signature Thrust is around, because they've been losing every fight, even close to the rush pit.
Just leave that part of the map, like, guys, this is not for us. You can have it.
Exactly, like, they should focus on defending. They've got, I don't know, right now,
they don't have,
they've got no one up, they don't have buybacks on, for example, if the Weaver dies now for being caught out of position, that's gonna cost them more than trying to get the Aegis.
Oh, they're gonna go into my pro here, but he just gets four stepped out. Is Aben actually gonna pursue this? Well, he does, of course, have the time lapse here, so he's kind of fine here. Well, Jeb, oh, Takuchi is gonna get dusted off. They're gonna just go after him right now. They just follow up all the stunts here and they. Takuchi away still. Oh, yeah, there's gonna be the fisher though. They're still headed. Well, hey, now he comes in. Fox uses his ghost scepter here. Well, he's gonna get pulled into the coxies and puts towards the Storm Spirit as well. Now, Primo, he pops his blade mill, but they don't care. They just kill him off. TA is still down for 12 seconds, but now they lost three people for 45 seconds plus, and this is gonna be at least one set of wrecks here with the Aghanim Scepter onto my pro. I do want to say one thing, this was probably the most successful game so far for Signature Thrust, or the, I mean, for Execration, the Rush Pit fight. They were able to steal the rush and get the Aegis as well, but still they kind of died after it. Resulting in this Rex push there. They just lost their melee Rex, range is still alive, but... Signature Trust seems to be okay with this. Is they gonna go after Lekels here? Trap popped it. He still has his BKB. Yeah, they're not gonna follow up in this pursuit.
Have you looked at the graph? Like, Signature Trust isn't really, like, by so much.
Yeah. 7.5k gold already for them. And about the same in experience here, also over the 7.5k gold mark.
Lekels is doing so much. Lekels? Is that how I pronounce him?
Yeah, Lekels.
Yeah, and... I mean, he's legendary and all that stuff, you know. Yeah. You just talk and ignore me. He's...
Dude, we need to see the big Rubick play for you.
Yeah,
like steal an Echo and win the game of the Echo.
Yeah, he can steal so many spells. I really like that they picked him. I like that pick. Is that, and he makes up for so much that they don't have as a team if he steals the right spells. My favorite thing about Rubick.
Yeah, just that crowd control. That's like the one thing that Signature Plus is a little bit lacking, and mostly crowd control, which use disables because they don't really have that much to keep people in place. Apart from a vortex and a lift, it's really lacking there. Might be looking at. Are they gonna build up a site here on the storm? That would actually be a good pickup. What do you think? Is he gonna go for Linkus as well on the storm
spirit? I'm actually not sure. Like, he's doing fine. But he already has a BKB. I don't know why he would go for a Lincoln.
Yeah, it's a little bit defensive here as my pro just hookshots in, but this was too aggressive. He's gonna get pulled back all the way back while my pro is stealing his damage. No, he's taking a lot of damage here from the course of Execration, but there are the four steps to save him, put him back. There's gonna be the totem put down now. This tier 3 is gonna take a fall here. There you go, just need one more hit, and Lekels is able to put it in. Oh, long zipping from Abang. He's gonna get forced by his team. He's just still surviving here. They're gonna try and keep him crowd control down, but he still has the timeless as Hehe dies here. He could be popped from Fimeout didn't have a BKB, I don't know what I was saying, but doesn't matter. Lumic goes in, finger on top of him, Fimeout dies. Lekels is the next one on the list here as he takes a lot of damage. Oh, there's gonna be the Echo Slap. Stolen. But Jeb tried to make the big play there, but it just didn't work.
They're hearing, they're listening to us talking about big plays from Rubick.
Yeah, sadly he kind of missed the aftershock passive there to really do the big damage here. But my pro, he has to start running away. He's gonna get found. I think he kind of accepted his fate right now as he's gonna die here to Nando.
Yeah, and the TA has an AC. It's actually... I don't know if you noticed that.
I haven't noticed that. I knew that he was going to build it, but I forgot to mention it or see it when he purchased it.
Awesome. Perfect.
As Weaver is also able to pick up his heart here. I haven't taken a look at the items for the best time, so those are the two cores for Execration. Nothing new on Fox here as they buy back Lekels. Clockwork is still about the same as well, and Lemmick is also the same here. Lekels just puts down call down to stall them. He has his butterfly, but as you saw last fight, it wasn't really able to save him. As we're probably gonna see MKB builds up now. They know that he has a butterfly, so they're able to just, you know, respond on that and get the MKBs. Well, there has been some time already. The Undying on the, with the Crimson Guard has had it for some time already. Rubick. Jeff hasn't really been able to pursue any further dreams of getting other items and Storm Spirit. He's still about the same here. He doesn't have enough money for his site, so. Will still take some time.
Yeah, he just. How many gold did he buy back? I don't know.
For the Storm, he doesn't have a buyback. 500 gold as well as a timer for 15 more seconds.
Yeah.
We're gonna be looking at Rush again. We're gonna see the timer in 1 minute. Let's do an RNG challenge here with you. How long do you think is gonna be the timer for Rush? You know, so after the 8 minute mark, you have between 8 and 11 minutes. So 0 to 3 minutes. In what time is it gonna spawn? Random
wow.
guess. Random guess.
Random guess.
Random guess.
2 minutes?
You gonna say 2 minutes?
I don't know. Wow.
Anything is good. 2 minutes is possible, so.
Like 49, I don't know.
Okay, you're gonna go with that, but we're gonna go into the fight here. Signature Thrust catching them off guard in the jungle. One support down, two support down. Buyback used on Fox as well as Lemmick. And they're maybe looking for some reinitiation here and get a good fight on Ebbing. Yeah, he's gonna go after Jeb here. Jeb, he's gonna steal Sakuchi and try to get out of here. Oh, he's just walking into Nando as the hookshot just hits his teammate. So we're gonna see the timer soon if you were correct. You're actually about correct here. It's not that far off. It's 1.5 minutes. 1.5 minutes.
So. Yep, I was right.
Good job there. I'm gonna ask you every game.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm just gonna send you random messages. Hey, what's the rush time gonna be?
I'll get my crystal magic thing
off. Oh, Nando finds Jeb, but Jeb goes invis, lifts him up, gonna throw him back here as well. As he just got a little bit of damage shown. 28 is not that much at the moment. Bang, he's a little bit aggressively forward. Call is gonna use. Primo just hits a bunch of creeps here. So he tries to get out right now. Abang is just able to get off his ultimate here, and Sakuchi out from here. Oh, there's gonna be the first kills to go, but there's gonna be the buyback on the Hehe. As Lakels is trying to fight up here, Nando is trying to man mode, but it's not working right now. Two down on the side of Execration, as Hehe is gonna do a long zip in after Fox. And he just uses buyback as well. Is he gonna be able to find Ebbing here? No, he's just Sakuchiing out to the good side. And well, Lemmick, he just got hit by the Rush by a homing miss on the other side of the map. A signature trust say, we're done. We want to end this. They're just going to go for the tier force into the Ancient. Buyback used. Are they going to go back now and just say, this is our victory with this? And it's just look at these crafts. They're so even. Like at this state of the game, this is neglectable. Oh no, yes, they're gonna get him. Pullback, do they have enough time to kill him? Oh, just before the call. Oh yes, they have. They get two kills here. This might just be the end of Execration, as they just have two cores to defend. He wasn't able to get off time lapse.
No,
nope. And with Reaver not able to get off his time lapse, he died there. Hypro with the Aghanim here doing a lot of damage. After that, he actually went for the Skadi and not for the Refresher build, so I'm kind of sorry about that. And they're just gonna go and get another lane of Rex here, and they seem to be willing to just go back for now. They don't want to risk it, as Roshan is up now, so that's probably gonna be the next point of contest again. And Execration, if they don't win this rush, this is most likely gonna be the GG there. They will lose an cheese as well as an Aegis there, and if they take one of those fights as they had before, it doesn't even matter if they get the Aegis. So we'll see if Execration is gonna follow your advice and just leave Roshan alone this time. But Nando seems to be eyeballing it. Oh, what? Okay, that Alpha Wolf was kind of too aggressive as Roshan starts to pummel on top of him. Signature Trust starts to rotate in on top of the Roshan pit right now. Hypro in front, Primo has a 4-step, but just 4-steps himself up onto the cliff here, but he's able to hookshot away to Fox here. The cow of their team helping him out there a little bit. What do you think? We're gonna start nearing the fine Raker territory here for one of the teams?
Pardon?
What do you think? Are we... it's okay, it's okay. What do you think? Are we reaching the point where we're gonna start seeing the fine Rapiers on either side?
I don't know. They both think... I don't think Signature would be, like, I think they're gonna be able to win, like, they've got a lot of more power, especially with, like, for example, how they picked off the Weaver. I don't know. It's a risky move to drop it, but if they go get the right kills, they can just go for the GP push. I don't know. Especially since the other team's angling for Rush. I'm not sure. I hate people who buy Rakes. I just, it stresses me out. It feels like the end of the world. Because you know it's gonna drop.
Oh, smoke pop. They're gonna see each other now. Hookshot in into my bro. They're able to kill him off in time. He's still alive now. Oh, yeah, he's gonna survive through all of this. As Nando is taking a whole lot of damage here. Epping is able to get up to the time lapse though, but just look at him. They're just surrounding him, laying in the damage here on top of him as Hayes. He's fighting up versus Fox here. Is Fox gonna die here? He, not without getting off an Echo Slam here. Slumic, he comes in, gets off a nice finger here, killing off Hey. He's down for 100 seconds. But the same goes for the TA on the side of Execration as they lose three people here. This is gonna be another Roshan for Signature Trust. Execration don't seem to be able to get a break at the Rosh pit. Yeah, they're gonna try and go for a bit of a Hail Mary here with Primo looking to go in with a hook shot, maybe still rush as well as the Aegis. He dropped his stick, he is all set up, but Lakels is trying. They're gonna go and try to stop all the exit points to get in there.
Are they gonna try and.
Well, they got. They
were. The courier? The courier is just like. Yeah.
Oh, it stole the plate mill! Oh, that was a really cute play there from Execration, and that will definitely hurt my pro here since it was his blade mill. Meaning that we won't be seeing a Shiva's guard anytime soon. But he got the cheese.
Yeah. Pick cheese any day.
Oh, that was a fun play. That's worth a highlight. Oh man, cheeky plays here from Execration, but realistically speaking, do you think it matters that much?
Not if they go for just the all-in push, but I don't know if they're gonna do that with Weaver just chilling there with a buyback. No one else has a buyback elf, like, literally.
For Execration or for both sides?
Pardon?
Oh, he's actually the only one in the whole map.
Yeah.
But the good thing is that Lakels, of course, has his Aegis, and on my pro they have a cheese. So
actually, signatures. What's it called? Oh God, what are words?
I want to say those Bleed. Things that come out of your mouth.
Oh God. Signature's lead is reaching a plateau, so if they don't do anything, I don't know, we might as well lose this, but we trust in the Storm and Gyra. Always trust.
No more trust in Jep here?
Well, of course there's trust in, of course. Expect to see huge plays, but I don't know.
The question is, is he able to make this big play? As he is a Rubik at 55 minutes in, it kind of gets hard to make those game-winning plays. Though I do still feel that Execration, their supports, have been playing a little bit better throughout the game than the ones from Signature Trust. Just getting off a lot of pickups on the course.
Yeah, but they've actually been in the like the supports have been doing better than at some points better than Signature's position. Please.
Well, they're gonna go in here. Lakels almost drops. Hehe goes in. Is able to kill him. I mean, before he can get off his ultimate. Yes, they do. He buys back. He comes back in here as well. But he's taking a lot of damage straight away as there's still no one dead on Signature Trust. There's gonna be the finger to kill of the Aegis. But they're just laying in the damage here onto the tower. As Lakels comes back, this is gonna be the tier 3 down. Finger stolen, but gets popped on the Lincoln. Oh my god, indeed. There is gonna be the Echo Slam. Hehe still alive. There's gonna be the Sword Whip. Just enough to keep him alive. And we're just gonna leave here right now. Is it gonna be the hook shot? No, it's kind of whiffed. It's my pro. He goes back in here. Okay, there's gonna be the Echo Slam stolen.
Yeah.
And They're able to lock them down for now. Abeng, is he gonna get out of here? Oh, he's get some damage here, but Nando, they're just gonna go for him. Hookshot from Primo kills off Hehe. He still has a buyback though. Buyback also used on a Rubik. Primo, oh, that kills. Call down. They're gonna hit Abeng here, but he just time lapse back. Does he really wanna go for Lakelsi? That's kind of dangerous as they lose. They're gonna get mega crazy right now, and this might just be the end for Execration in the Crosshair Gaming Arena. Well, they're trying to hold them desperately. Primo gets off another hookshot. Goes Infiz here as they're still looking for him. They're gonna get another two kills here for Signature Trust. This is gonna be the end. Abeng sees it. He calls GG. Yeah. Signature Trust win in a 56 minute game. In Rubik we trust. That's the end.
Yeah. Rubik is magic. Or something like that. Yeah.
But okay, ladies and gentlemen, this was the Crosshair Gaming Arena number 5. The winner of this match between Signature Trust and Execration of this quarterfinal was, of course, Signature Trust. They're going to be facing up versus either Arcanas. Oh, there was already ended Arcanas between MSI, whatever they're called here, and Arcanas won this one. So it's going to be Trust versus Arcanas next. In the semi-final here, we're here on the Swiss DC channel with Sander, and I'm gonna so pronounce your name wrong, Vasi.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, it was close. I'm learning. I'm slowly learning here. But guys, follow me at Madness Casting. Also follow, of course, Swiss DC everywhere. Follow our channel. We are gonna be putting out as much content as again. Follow us on our Twitter and Facebook. Just click in the panel there. And I hope to see you guys all in our further casts. And this is Sander signing out. You got any last things to say?
No, just thank you for having me. And I'm sorry for being so confused and awkward.
It's okay.
That was fun.
Well, that was us. We're signing out.